Did anyone notice what the silent kid was building in secret? Freshman year, Mr. Hanley taught intro to engineering. One of those teachers who tried way too hard to connect with teens using dad jokes and YouTube references. He'd start every class with, "All right, brainiacs, let's build the future." The class had its usual mix of overachievers, kids who just wanted an easy A, and then there was Elias. Elias sat in the back corner, hoodie up, never spoke, not even once. Like, literally not a single word. Some kids joked that he was a vampire, or that maybe he just didn't have vocal cords. The truth? Nobody knew. He didn't talk to other students. Never raised his hand, turned in his assignments with a scribbled name and zero emotion. Mr. Hanley tried everything, calling on him, encouraging him, even offering one-on-one help after class. Nothing. Elias would just look at him with those flat, gray eyes blink, and go back to sketching weird diagrams in the margins of his notebook. Circuits, gears, pulleys, always mechanical stuff, but incredibly detailed. Everyone figured he was just a loner, maybe even a little off. But then, around February, strange things started happening. Small mechanical parts went missing from the supply room. Screws, wires, Arduino boards. Nothing big, just odd. A faint buzzing sound would sometimes echo from the janitor's closet. Next to room 112 once, a student swore they saw a red light blink behind the mop bucket. Mr. Hanley joked it was a ghost. Nobody thought much of it, until one Friday morning. Mr. Hanley walked into his classroom and froze. Standing at the front of the room was a 5-foot-tall robot, not a kit-built one. This thing was handcrafted from scrap metal, wiring, plastic tubes. It looked like a prototype straight out of a sci-fi movie. Its head was a 3D-printed dome with two blinking blue LED eyes. Its chest was an old speaker grill, and it breathed. You could hear a rhythmic hiss from a makeshift piston system inside. Everyone stared. Then the robot spoke. "Good morning, class. Mr. Hanley, I have completed phase one," the class screamed. Some kids thought it was a prank. Mr. Hanley nearly dropped his coffee. And then from the back of the room, Elias stood up. He walked to the front, no hoodie this time. He reached behind the robot, tapped a few keys on a built-in keypad, and looked directly at Mr. Hanley. "I didn't mean to scare anyone," Elias said quietly. "I just needed a voice." Silence. Mr. Hanley stared. "You built this?" Elias nodded. "From junk, mostly. I've been working in the janitor's closet during lunch. I couldn't talk, so I made something that could." Turns out, Elias had selective mutism, a severe anxiety disorder that made verbal communication nearly impossible in social situations. But he wasn't dumb. Far from it. He'd been studying robotics on his own since he was 9. YouTube, online courses, old MIT lectures, the diagrams in his notebook, they were original blueprints. He had created a voice-controlled, semi-autonomous robot with parts he salvaged from discarded printers and VCRs. The voice the robot used was Elias's, a recording he'd carefully programmed into the system. Word spread like wildfire. The school's STEM coordinator called it the most advanced, independent student project they'd ever seen. A robotics engineer from a nearby university came to visit and offered Elias a summer internship on the spot. By the end of the year, Elias wasn't just speaking, he was presenting through his robot, demonstrating voice synthesis, AI pathfinding, and environmental sensors. Mr. Hanley would still start every class with, "Let's build the future," but now he'd glance at Elias and say, "Or in your case, build a better one."